This episode of Film Riot is brought to you by Domain.com.
Welcome to Film Riot Mondays. Today, as always, we got some questions. This time, all coming from Twitter. We realized we weren't showing Twitter quite enough love, so now we decided to reach over there and just stroke its head. Twitter, be our friend. I'm working on an action movie with someone who insists on locking the camera down. Could this work? I doubt it will look good. It could work, but it depends on what you mean by locked down. I mean, if you're talking about a tripod that's just sitting stationary all the time, for me, in my opinion, that would come off very boring and very amateurish. You're not within the action, you're not moving with the action, you're a stationary object. If that's what you're going for, it could work, but I feel like that would be a very specific thing and it would be a very specific style you would be going for. It doesn't necessarily have to be handheld, but I would say get on a dolly, a steady cam, something like that to add some excitement into your shots to go along with the action. Otherwise, it's probably gonna water down all of it. And if it's an independent production, I would probably suggest handheld of some kind, whether it's on a rig or a steady cam, because that's gonna help you sell the action, because it's really hard, unless you have a stunt team, to really sell action scenes. How to get rid of the amateur look. Please, 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 please. We've talked about this a lot, and actually, if you're talking about purely look, meaning cinematography, definitely check out our cinematography episodes on YouTube. We did a whole month of it, right?
I think so.
I think it was a solid 4 or 5 episodes talking about how to get a better look to your film. The film look is something a little hard to establish. A lot of times where you'll go wrong is crushing the blacks too much. It starts to look a little video-ish. It's a balance between a bunch of things. So one, it's how you shoot it. What's the lighting like? What are your subjects to look like? What does your background look like? What colors are you using? Is it one flat color? Then when you, where you put the camera, what angles are you using? Is this a boring home video-esque looking angle? Are you shooting 24p or 30? You should be shooting 24p if you want it to feel more like film to your audience. And then in post, it's, you know, about the color grading you finally end up with. So it's this grouping of a ton of things, not just one thing, that will give you a better look to your film. But check out those cinematography episodes. I think they'll help you out a lot. Do you think we've seen the beginning of the end for old school special effects artists like Tom Savini? Since CG is getting good? No, absolutely not. I mean, is it possible for the future? Maybe, but the best visual effects that I have ever seen up until this point in even the most modern of films is when they're mixing live action with CG. When it's purely CG, I can pretty much always tell and it breaks it a little bit. So no, I think practical effects are always around. Plus, when you have an actor, you want to be able to put on prosthetics and things like that onto your actor. So I definitely don't think that's an art form that's going to go away at all. Just like I think film will always be around in some way, shape, or form. Although those two things actually don't go together now that I think about it. To answer your question, in my opinion, no. Hey Ryan, what's the best way to overcome the crop ratio on a DSLR, which is not full frame, just step back, but wider lens? Either one of those that you just mentioned will work. You can back up or you can get wider lenses. The only thing is each one is gonna have a different effect on your image. If you're backing up, you're still having a longer focal length, which means you're going to be compressing the background to your actor, which means the background will seem closer to your actor. Now, if that's what you want, great. But if it's not, you're gonna need to get some wider lenses. So both of them will work, but they will have very different emotional impacts on your audience. So you gotta make sure you're doing the right thing for your shot. Do you have any plans to buy a new camera in a tense? There's a bunch of cameras that I desperately want, but none that I'm gonna buy right now. We're doing pretty well with the 5D. Right now we're borrowing the Epic from Kessler and we've been using it on and off, but we can't use it all the time on a weekly basis because the workflow is a little too slow to be able to push out a show like this all the time. So our workhorse is still the 5D and it works really, really well for us in our pipeline. So for now, it's more about borrowing and renting cameras for bigger productions than spending a ton of money on the camera that's probably just gonna sit there until we do bigger productions. It just wouldn't make sense. So it's something to think about. Don't drool over a camera so much that you run out and get it when it's not gonna make you more money. I mean, if you're doing enough freelance work to where you can buy that camera and start billing yourself out at a higher rate, then that makes all the sense in the world for you. Otherwise, get something that's good like a Blackmagic or a 5D Mark III, something like that, and rent the bigger cameras when those jobs come around. How long do you think it will be that shooting in 4K will be the standard? Shooting in 4K isn't necessarily the standard. There's tons of different things shot on 2K, blown up to 4K, things shot at 4K, and tons of stuff right now shot at 5K. I mean, every camera that's using the Red Epic is usually shooting on 5K, which is a ton of films right now. So that's not really the standard. Projecting is the standard at 4K right now. How long that be? I mean, that's not my area of expertise, so I couldn't possibly say. I'd be talking on my butt, and I don't usually do that. Usually. Domain.com is the place to go if you're trying to get yourself on the internet. And what do I mean by that? A presence of some kind. Whether you got a film that you're trying to display like we did with Tell, or you want a blog, which I love. I love me some bloggers. I'm attached to quite a few blog sites. Whatever it is that you're trying to do on the internet, domain.com really is the best place to go get that set up. You get your domain name, you get your hosting, and it's easy as can be. I mean, I really hate some of the other services where you get there and there's just 10,000 buttons and I don't know what to click. And then you click something and you're like, how did I get here? And then it's trying to upsell you everything and its mom. Domain.com is not like that. It made it really, really easy to go in and get my domain, my hosting up and going. I mean, we had the Tell website up and I think a day, which is insane. I did something like that before and that was not the case. And the great thing is if you use the coupon code FILMRIOT at checkout, you can get 15% off domain names, web hosting today just by using that coupon code, because domain, they loves you. They loves you. So get the coupon code action happening, get your website up and going, and get your name out there. So this is the end of the episode, but before I get to my short film suggestion of the week, just wanted to talk about the Monday challenge again. I hope you guys are cracking away at those, since we do have that sweet prize of $500 from RhettKessler.com. But more importantly, I forgot to tell you guys that we did do an episode that could help you out, which was about a car chase, which you could find right here. We gave some ideas of how to safely pull off a car chase. So if you're gonna do anything, just make sure you're not actually breaking the law. You're not actually breaking any speed limits. You're doing this safely and you're using filmmaking tricks to make it thrilling. And also the other thing, because a lot of people I've noticed have made some discouraged comments about being in the episode or doing the Monday challenge and not being picked. But here's the thing, as we've told you a million times, you're getting recognition from your peers and we're all watching each other's stuff and commenting and it's getting passed around and you're getting views. But another thing that's really cool is you're constantly making something new, which means you're constantly improving and you're constantly making new content for your demo reel. Like, we just put something out where we needed some demo reels from people to see their work, and now you're getting enough work together that if somebody needs a demo reel from you, you could take all these money challenges you did, since a lot of you guys have made some impressive work, and put it together and make a solid reel. So there's a lot of advantages to doing this, which all of them just make me really excited for why we're doing it. But either way, just make sure you're working on that Monday challenge for the Rent Kessler credit, because that is some sweet stuff. But now moving on to my short film suggestion of the week. And this one is a really different from anything I've suggested before. I'm not sure if we've ever suggested an animation before, and this isn't a straight animation. It's a mixture of live action plates with a main animated character that we follow, and it's called Gloom. And it's done by David Elwell and Gareth Hughes, and it's really great. It's not your standard short film where there's any form of a narrative to it, and it's very short. It's more like an exploration into emotion, and they have this character, which I absolutely love, and the way that they were able to pull these emotions out of this character and get me to feel for it with such little expression was very impressive to me. They also shot it on a T3i, and it looks freaking fantastic. So it is a great example how just two very talented guys with no money and a Canon T3i, which is a very cheap camera, can go out and make something that's absolutely fantastic. It also has a really great score that definitely helps push the emotion as well. So check it out here. It is a very inspiring short film, especially for all of us low no budgeters. So check it out, show it some love, comment it on whatnot, and I'll see you guys next week when we have the Monday challenge.